بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم أما بعد Well, praise to Allah who has given us bounties more than we can perceive and fathom. The question is why does this insan only turn to Allah after needs? When a person is healthy, wealthy, conditions are good, then he is oblivious of Allah. This oblivion makes the heart deteriorate and get darker and darker. This person cannot see Allah anymore. Even if he's doing ibadah, his ibadah will be filled with darkness. And he progresses where he perceives every accomplishment and achievement to himself. He attributes it to himself. And he starts thinking, his perception eventually takes him to taking credit for himself. And these bounties of Allah are now used for disobedience. And when he's at the climax of negligence, Allah takes him to task for that. أَخْذَ أَزِيزٍ مُقْتَدِيرٍ So Deen, Quran is a cure, and until a person does not go for blood tests and x-rays to the spiritual doctors, to the ulama muttaqeen, the ahlullah, go out in the path of Allah and learn this deen, spend some time in the company of sahabat, pious company, then a person will not realize how much darkness they're in. Somebody came to Ibrahim Adham rahimahullah and said, Ya Aba Ishaq, ma lana nad'u fala yustajabu lana. We make a dua, but our dua is not accepted. So he replied, لِأَنَّكُمْ تَدْعُونَ بِقُلُوبٍ مَاتَتْ You people are making dua for a disease in your heart which has caused death of your hearts. Ten qualities. عَرَفْتُمُ اللَّهَ فَلَمْ تُؤَدُّوا حَقَّهُ You have recognized Allah, but you have not fulfilled the haqq of Allah. وَزَعَمْتُمْ أَنَّكُمْ تُحِبُّونَ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ You perceive that you love the Nabi of Allah. وَتَرَكْتُمْ سُنَّتَهُ But you've abandoned his sunnah. وَقَرَأْتُمُ الْقُرْآنِ فَلَمْ تَعَمَلُوا بِهِ You are reading Quran, you are making a lot of tilawat, but your lives are void of practice. وَكَلْتُمْ نِعْمَ اللَّهِ فَلَمْ تُؤَدُّوا شُكْرَهَا You have engaged and enjoyed the bounties of Allah, but you've not fulfilled the gratitude. وَقُلْتُمْ إِنَّ الشَّيْطَانَ عَدُوكُمْ You accept that shaitan is your open enemy. وَلَمْ تُخَالِفُوهُ But you've not opposed him. وَقُلْتُمْ إِنَّ الْجَنَّةَ حَقٌ وَلَمْ تَعَمَلُوا لَهَا You say, Jannah is true, paradise is true, akhirat is true. But you're not doing actions to show that you want this Jannah. وَقُلْتُمْ إِنَّ النَّارَ حَقٌ وَلَمْ تَهْرَبُوا مِنْهَا You are saying, Jahannam and hellfire is true. But you're not running away from this fire. وَقُلْتُمْ إِنَّ الْمَوْتَ حَقٌّ وَلَمْ تَسْتَعِدُّوا لَهُ You are sure you will die and you say death is true. It's inevitable. But you've done no preparation. You've made no effort to justify your death to show that you are genuine and sincere. وَاشْتَغَلْتُمْ بِعُيُوبِ النَّاسِ وَنَسِيْتُمْ عُيُوبَكُمْ You've engaged in searching for flaws of people, but you've forgotten your own flaws. وَدَفَنْتُمْ مَوْتَاكُمْ وَلَمْ تَعْتَبِرُوا Janazas upon janazas are passing in front of you, your friend, your family, your relative, your close one. Day and night you are hearing the alan, but you do not take lesson. So, deen is the solution. We are making tilawat of Quran, but we need to see how much of this tilawat is in our lives. Have we acquired taqwa? لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ What a sifat of a muttaqi. Somebody wrote to Ibn Zubair describing taqwa. أَلَا إِنَّ لِأَهْلِ التَّقْوَى عَلَامَاتُ يُعْرَفُونَ بِهَا There are signs of the muttaqeen. And they will able to see it clearly, vividly. Man radiya bil qada. Be happy with the decision of Allah. Don't complain, don't make stories. Allah has decreed something, it's my Allah's decision. I'm in favor of my Allah's decision. Don't oppose the qada of Allah. Wa sabr ala al bala. Calamities come. My Allah is Hakim, He knows why. I am happy with that. Wa shakar ala al-na'ma. Allah has given you so much bounties. Be grateful. Use it in the obedience of Allah. Wa sadaqa fil lisan. And He is truthful in His speech. If your tongue can speak lies, your action, your life will be a lie. Wa waffa bil wa'd wal ahd. And the promises, agreements, transactions, fulfillit. Wa tala ahkam al Quran. And you study deen, you know the ahkam and the awamir of Allah. And you seek knowledge of deen, knowledge of the Quran, and practice on it. وَإِنَّمَا الْإِمَامُ سُوقٌ مِّنَ الْأَسْوَاقِ. The ulama, the mashayikh are like bazaars. If you've got taqwa in you, فَإِنْ كَانَ مِنْ أَهْلِ الْحَقِّ حَمَلَ إِلَيْهِ. That the people of haqq will go to these ulama, take the haqq to them, and seek from this marketplace to strive in haqq. وَإِنْ كَانَ مِنْ أَهْلِ الْبَاطِلِ حَمَلَ إِلَيْهِ. أَهْلَ الْبَاطِلِ. And the people of Batil, even if they are doing wrong, they will go to the ulama. I've done this wrong. How do I make tawbah? How do I repent? I did this transaction. My zakat is outstanding for so many years. I got so much qazai umri. My will is not in order. I filled in the will, but I don't know the formalities of inheritance. How do I make sure I get it right? Hasan Basri rahimahullah saying, Inna li ahli taqwa alamat. What are the signs of the muttaqin? Sidqul hadith. Again, speaking the truth. Wafa bil ahd. Fulfilling promises. Silatul rahim. To join family ties. Wa rahmatul du'afa. And to have mercy to the weak. To help those that are in needy. Wa qillatul fakhr. And not to have any pride or arrogance. وَبَذْلُ الْمَعَرُوفِ. And to spend in good avenues. وَقِلَّةُ الْمُبَاهَ لِلنَّاسِ. And do things for Allah. You want to challenge people in dunya. You want to show you've achieved something. No. Show achievement for good deeds. وَحُسْنُ الْخُلُقِ. And to have good character. So deen, the amal of deen. We need to have yaqeen. To be checking how much of this is coming to our life. Everything will have an effect. Quran has its effect. Salah has its effect. Dhikr has its effect. The problem is not with the amal, it's the problem is with me. We have to have yaqeen. We know sugar sweetens. We know its effect. So, amal has its effect. Good has its effect. Bad has its effect. That's why Abdullah ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu used to say, إِنَّ لِلْحَسَنَ. If you do good deeds, see the effects. ذِيَعَنْ فِي الْوَجْهِ. Your face will be illuminated. We're trying to illuminate our faces with anti-aging creams. Illuminate it with good deeds. وَنُورًا فِي الْقَلْبِ. The dark black hearts will be lightened. وَسَعَةً فِي الرِّزْقِ. We are looking for sustenance and barakah. In amal is barakah and sustenance. وَقُوَّةً فِي الْبَدْنِ. And it'll give you strength in your body. وَمَحَبَّةٍ فِي قُلُوبِ الْخَلْقِ. Allah will put love in the hearts of the creation for you. وَإِنَّ لِلسَّيِّئَةِ لَذُلْمَةِ. What does bad deeds do? Darkness in the heart. إِسْوِدَادٍ فِي الْوَجْهِ. It will blacken the face. وَوَهْنًا فِي الْبَدْنِ. And the body will become weak. وَنَقْصًا فِي الرِّزْقِ. And barakah in risk will be snatched. Person will strive and struggle and run from one corner to the other. Just when he thought so he got it right, something else went wrong. Just when he thought so he got it right, another door closed. وَبُغْذٍ فِي قُلُوبِ الْخَلْقِ. And the creation will have animosity and hatred for this person. So, making tilawat of Quran, we were busy with the knee of taqwa and the benefits of taqwa. Number 15, protection from the plotting of the enemies. Some people came to Hazrat Mawlana Imam al-Hassan rahimahullah and asked him that there were riots in India at that period, and asked for some advice, and he just told him this advice here: وَإِن تَسْبِرُوا وَتَتَّقُوا لَا يَذُرُّكُمْ كَيْدُهُمْ شَيْئًا. Tell the Ummah to be patient on all difficulties and hardships, be happy with the decision of Allah, and abstain from sin. See every amr of Allah, stick to it, and stay far away from guna. Nobody will touch you. The ulama that were there were as if those ayat just came down to us. Just as if came down, alan was made. And they say within a few days, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protected the Muslims and protected their properties. Bala in tasbiru wa tattaqu wa ya'tukum min fawrihim hadha yumdidkum rabbukum. Allah's help, Allah's nusrat is with the muttaqeen. وَنَجَّيْنَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَكَانُوا يَتَّقُونَ. The people of Iman and the people of Taqwa, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala preserved them. So Taqwa is a door for protection, for hifadat. In the era of Hazrat Khilafat of Umar radiallahu anhu, 19th year after Hijri, sent an army to Rome. Abdullah ibn Huzafa Sahmi radiallahu anhu was taken prisoner by the Romans, and he was brought before the king. So the king said, Inni a'radu alayka an tatanassara wa tatruka al-Islam. Become a Christian, leave Islam. Fa'in falta thalika khalaytu sabilak wa akramtu mathwak. I will give you possessions, all that Arabs do not. I'll give you share from my kingdom. I will honor you. I will set you free. I will give you my daughter's hand in marriage, in some narrations. His reply was, if you were to give me all that you possess and all the possessions of the Arabs to forsake my deen, even for a moment, I will not do it. فَغَضِبَ قَيْسَرٌ. So he became upset, he became angry, and he said, إِذَنْ أَقْتُلُكْ. Then I'll have to kill you. So the Sahabi replied, أَنْتَ وَمَا تُرِيد. Do what you wish, do as you like. So he said, do what you want. So the king gave orders that he should be crucified. He commanded the archers to shoot. So he was tied up and to shoot close to his hands and feet. And as the arrows came, he said, are you ready to become a Christian? He refused. So then Qaisar, seeing he's very stubborn, he said, prevent food and drink. فَمَنْعُوهُمَا عَنْهُ حَتَّى كَادَ أَن يَمُوت. They gave no provisions to him until he was close to his last moments of hungerness. And then they brought فَأَحْذَرُوا لَهُ خَمْرًا وَلَحْمَ خِنْزِيرٌ. Alcohol, wine and pork. فَلَمَّا رَآهُمَا عَبُدُ اللَّهِ قَالَ وَاللَّهِ إِنِّي لَعَلَمُ أَنِّي لَمُضْطَرٌ. By the oath of Allah, I know under these circumstances it will be permissible in my deen, but I don't want to give the kuffar the opportunity to gloat. And he never came close to the food. So Qaisar was informed of this. So they said, okay, give him food, replace the food with good halal food. Then umira an tudkhal alayhi imra hasna, a beautiful, gorgeous, stunning, attractive damsel was brought before him. Tata'arrad lahu bil fahisha, to seduce and entice him and lure him. But on her every attempt she failed. فَلَمَّا رَأَدْ ذَٰلِكَ خَرَجَتْ وَهِيَ غَاضِبًا. When she's seen, imagine you now endowed with beauty. And here is a person who is greatly in need. And you try to entice him, and he doesn't budge one bit. وَقَالَتْ. So what she said, أَدْخَلْتُمُونِي عَلَىٰ رَجُلٍ لَا أَدْرِي أَهُوَ بَشَّرَ أَوْ حَجَرٌ. Subhanallah, Subhanallah, Ajib. You put me in the company of a person, I don't even know if he's human or stone. Is he a rock, a boulder? وهو والله لا يدري أني أنا أنثى أم ذكر. Does he even know whether I'm male or female? He didn't even notice me. So the king got the news, so he gave orders that a big vessel of copper to be brought, heated up, and while the Sahabi was watching, the Muslim prisoners were brought and thrown in, and his bones scorched and was nothing left. So he said, do you want to become a Christian? So he refused. So Abdullah then was commanded to be thrown into the burning cauldron. And he started crying. So the king said, summon him, call him back. Maybe he's ready to accept Christianity. And he asked him, now you are crying now, what's the reason? He said, أَبْكِي وَاللَّهِ لِأَنَّهُ لَيْسَ لِي إِلَّا نَفْسٌ وَاحِدَةٌ. I am not crying because of the fire or the flames or the fear of death. I have only one soul to be thrown in this fire. وَلَقَدْ وَدِيتُ لَوْ كَانَ لِي بِعَدَدِ شَعَرِ رَأْسِ نُفُوسٍ. If only I had as many souls as there are the hairs on my head, on my forehead, on my head. If I had so much lives as hair that I have, تَمُوتُ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ, to die, to undergo this torture for the sake of Allah. So the king realizes he's losing the battle. So he said, قَبِّلْ رَأْسِي. If you kiss my head, I will set you free. Abdullah radiallahu anhu said, and will you release the Muslim prisoners as well? So the king said, done deal. He kissed his forehead and released him with the other Muslim prisoners when they arrive in Madinat al-Munawwara. And Umar bin Khattab radiallahu anhu heard the story. He said, حَقٌ عَلَى كُلِّ مُسْلِمٍ. It is the right of every Muslim to kiss the head of Hazrat Abdullah ibn Huzafa radiallahu anhu. وَأَنَا أَبْدَعَ, and I will start first. And فَقَامَ سَيِّدُنَا عُمَرْ فَقَبَّلَ رَأْسَهُ. He was the first to kiss the head of the Sahabi. In the narration of Zuhri, he reports that somebody complained to the Nabi of Allah about Hazrat Abdullah ibn Huzafa, that he joked a lot and spoke many useless things. So Rasulullah said, leave him alone because he has a heart that loves Allah and his Rasul. Leave him alone because he has a heart that loves Allah and his Rasul. So taqwa opens up doors beyond comprehension. A person can be in the jaws of death. He'll be seeing death in front of him, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will preserve and protect his servants. The amal for today is that Marthad ibn Abdullah used to go to the masjid, and the narrator says, every time I seen him enter in the masjid, illa wa fi kummihi sadaqatun, that in his sleeves he had sadaqa, imma fulus wa imma khubzun wa imma kamhun, that in his sleeve he had either money, bread, wheat. Sometimes I would see onions, so I said, why are you carrying onions? There is a smell that may affect the musallin, people reading salat. So he said that, I've heard the Sahaba saying, and I've got nothing in my house. This was the last ingredient I had in my house. And I've heard Sahaba saying that the Nabi of Allah said, ذِلُّ الْمُؤْمِنِ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ صَدَقَتُهُ, that the shade of a believer on the day of Qiyamah will be his sadaqah, it will be his charity. كُلُّ مْرِئٍ فِي ذِلِّ صَدَقَتِهِ حَتَّى يُقْضَى بَيْنَ النَّاسِ, that every servant will be under the shade of his charity until judgment is passed. So to give a sadaqah, charity, in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the tawfiq of making amal. وَآخِرُ دَعْوَانَا أَنِ الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ.